Hello everybody, today we are going to see next concept, that is finding the remaining zeros of a polynomial. Okay, already we have seen what is cubic polynomial. Okay, we have seen some points which are depend on the cubic polynomial. Okay, now here see, we have one polynomial, biquadratic polynomial. Why it is biquadratic polynomial? Because this degree of this polynomial is 4, so that is biquadratic polynomial. See here, what is our concept? Finding remaining zeros of a polynomial. Remaining zeros of a polynomial. As you know that this is biquadratic polynomial, so there are 4 zeros. You will get definitely 4 zeros for this polynomial. Okay. So how to find out the remaining zeros if 2 zeros are given? Okay, here 2 zeros are given. See, find all the zeros of a polynomial f of x is equal to 2x raised to 4 minus 3x cubed minus 3x square plus 6x minus 2. If 2 of its zeros are root 2 and minus 2. Okay, means here 2 zeros are given. Root 2 and minus root 2 is given, and the remaining 2 zeros we need to find. Okay, so as we know that how to solve this, that we are going to think about this, but before this we must know this. See, if x is equal to alpha, x is equal to alpha is a zero of the polynomial. If x is equal to alpha is the zero of this polynomial, of a polynomial, then we can say x minus alpha is equal to zero. This is a factor of this polynomial. This is a factor of this polynomial. Okay, we have seen this, how to find out zeros. Once again, see, if x is equal to alpha is the zero of this any polynomial, then x minus alpha will be the factor of this polynomial, of that polynomial. Okay, so on the basis of this basic introduction, we are going to solve this. Understood? So now see here, they have told us root 2 and minus root 2 are the zeros of the polynomial. Okay, so we can say the value of x, root 2 and minus root 2 are the zeros of f of x 2x raised to 4 minus 3x cubed minus 3x square plus 6x minus 2. Okay, these are the two zeros. According to this, okay, what we can see here, x is equal to root 2 and x is equal to minus 2. Okay, if root 2 and minus root 2 are the zeros of the polynomial, then we can say x minus root 2 is the factor of this polynomial. Also, this minus root 2 will move here, that will be plus 2. X plus root 2 is also zero of this factor of this polynomial. Okay, zeros are given, so from the zeros we have taken the factors of this. Understood? So these two factors we have two factors of the polynomial, of the given polynomial, and with the help of this we are going to find out remaining. Getting everyone? Okay, so these are the two factors. So what we are going to do here, we will find out the product of this. Okay, so see here, a plus b and a minus b. So directly we can use here identity, that is a plus b, a minus b, what gives us a square minus b square. So like that, here we can say x square minus root 2 square, x square minus root 2 square. Okay, so x square minus root 2 square, we can write x square minus root 2 square into 2. Okay, x square minus 2. This is the product of these two factors. Okay, so x square minus 2. So this is our divisor. By this, we are going to divide here. By long division method, we are going to use here. And we will find out remaining factors. Getting everyone? How we got this? Two zeros were given. If zeros are given, we have taken x is equal to root 2, x is equal to minus 2. So if these are two zeros, then these are two factors of the given polynomial. So we have taken the product of the factors, and that product, by that product, we are going to divide into this by division algorithm. Division algorithm, what says? Dividend is equal to divisor, dividend is equal to divisor multiplied by quotient plus remainder.
Okay.
So according to the division algorithm, we are going to solve this by log division. Okay. So now already we have seen this in class 9, how to divide. So that polynomial I am taking here, 2x raised to 4 minus 3x cube minus 3x square plus 6x minus 2. Okay. Now our divisor is x square minus 2. X square minus 2. Okay. So now we are going to divide by this quadratic polynomial to this biquadratic. Okay. So now we need to think about this. Here power is 6 raised to 4. See carefully. Once again we are going to see each and every step. Okay. How to divide that we have seen in class 9. Once again see carefully. Here the power is x raised to 4. We have to multiply to the divisor by such a factor. After the multiplication, you will get the first step should be same. This first term should be same. Okay, like that we need to find out the factor. See here, we want x raised to 4, here x square is available. So first x square we need to multiply. X square will get x raised to 4. What is the coefficient of x raised to 4? 2. So with this we need 2 also. 2x raised to 2. Okay, when you find out the product of this, that time we get 2x raised to 4. Okay, getting everyone? Why 2x raised to 2 we have taken? The product of this 2 or product of this and first term of the divisor will give 2x raised to 4. Like that we need to choose the factor. Okay, so if you are not getting, you can take like this also. See, divisor is x square minus 2, divisor you can take separately. Initially you can use this method also. We want x raised to 4, so we need here x square. We want 2 also with x raised to 4, so here we will take 2. Suppose we will find out product of this 2, what we will get? 2x raised to 4, 2 into 2, this is minus sign will come here, 2 into 2, 4 and x square. 2x raised to 4 minus 4x square, that is the product. Okay, so that product we can write here, 2x raised to 4 minus 4x square. Okay, now as usual here minus sign, due to this minus sign this is going to change, this will be plus. Okay, now 2x raised to 4 and this 2x raised to 4 plus minus will be cancelled. Now see here minus 3x cube plus 4x square, minus 3x cube plus 4x square. Is it possible? Is it possible subtraction or addition according to the sign? Is it possible? Not possible, because see here x cube and x square, these are totally unlike terms. So we cannot use here, we cannot do addition or subtraction. So what I am going to do here, see, this minus 4x square term I am going to take here, minus 4x square I am going to take here, because here x square, that addition or subtraction is possible because terms are like. Getting everyone? So now here due to this minus, this is going to be plus. Getting everybody? Now minus 3x square plus 4x square. Okay, minus plus will be minus, 4 minus 3 will be x square plus x square. Okay, plus 1x square, that is x square, plus 6x minus 2 we can take here, and what is remaining from this? Minus 3x cube. Minus 3x cube is remaining, that I have taken as minus 3x cube, this is plus sign, plus x square plus 6x minus 2. Getting everybody? Now our target is this 3x cube. Okay, we have to multiply by such a number or such a factor to the divisor, then you will get minus 3x cube. Okay, so I need to multiply by minus 3, so I will take here minus 3. Here x cube are there, x cube is 0, is there. Okay, here only x square is there, so I need one more x. See carefully, minus 3x into x square, what is going to come? Minus 3x cube, minus 3x cube. Okay, so this product will give you this first term. Okay, so of remainder. So now here we can multiply this minus 3x cube, product of this minus 3x into minus 2 will be change into plus, 3 to the 6x. Again you see here, x square, 3 to the 6x. Okay, minus into minus will be plus, 3 to the 6x. So that we have taken here. Now here what is going to come? According to this minus, subtraction we need to do. So this will change into plus, this will change into minus. Okay, so 3x cube minus 3x cube plus 3x cube will be will get cancelled. What is remaining here? X square plus 6x minus 6x also can get cancelled because plus minus additive inverse, and this minus 2 will remain. Okay, x square minus 2. Now see here, x square minus 2, here x square minus 2. So which factor is needed here? 1 plus 1. Okay, when you will multiply by 1, that time will be same, you will get 2. Okay, so here I am taking plus 1. So 1 into x square will be x square minus 2. 1 into x square minus 2 will be x square minus 2. Minus sign, this will be changed into plus, and finally remainder is 2. Okay, here division complete because remainder is 2. Now, if you see at the place of quotient, we have a quadratic equation. We have a quadratic equation. So that equation we need to factorize. That equation we need to factorize. So easily we can factorize by splitting middle term. So that I am taking here 2x square minus 3x, 2x square minus 3x plus 1. Okay. This is a quadratic polynomial, so we can factorize. As you know, we need to find out product of this. 2 into 1 is 2, 2 into 1 is 2, 2 we need to factorize in such a way, sum should be minus 3 and product should be 2. Okay, so what are the factors? What are the factors? Minus 2 into minus 1, see product of these 2 is minus 2 into minus 1 will be plus 2, sum you will take minus 2, minus 1 will be minus. So this is the correct way which is satisfying both the conditions. Okay, so now we are going to put here 2x square minus 2x minus x minus 2x minus x plus 1. Okay, so now from this we can take 2x common, 2x we can take common. So what is remaining here? X minus 1. 2x we have taken common, x minus 1. Now here from this we can take common minus 1. Minus 1, so what is going to remain here? X, and this plus will change into minus because minus sign you have taken common. So now brackets are same, x minus 1, x minus 1, you will take here x minus 1, another bracket 2x, 2x minus 2. Okay, so we can say x minus 1 is equal to 0 or 2x minus 1 is equal to 0. So x is equal to what is going to come? 1 or x, 2x is equal to 0 plus 1 will be 1, so x is equal to 1 by 2. X is equal to 1 by 2. Okay, so these are the zeros. So how many zeros we have now? These two zeros already they have given. So zeros are root 2, minus root 2, 1, and 1 by 2. Okay, so these are the four zeros. Got it, everyone? See carefully. How to find out remaining zeros? Okay, see here we are going to see one more example. Obtain all the zeros of the polynomial f of x is equal to 3x raised to 4 plus 6x cube minus 2x square minus 10x minus 5. If two of its zeros are root 5 by 3 and minus root 5 by 3, okay, two zeros are given. Same example is given this, before this we have seen example, there are also given two zeros, here also given two zeros, okay. So procedure is same, only what we are going to do, we are going to solve this by division algorithm in the last, okay. So that we will see, the same we can use in the last example also. Okay, now see carefully what we are going to do here. Two zeros are given. As I told you, these are the zeros of the polynomial. So factors will be, so x minus root 5, x minus root 5 by 3. Okay, is a factor because x is equal to root 5 by 3. So x minus root 5 by 3 will come here. And here what is going to come? X this is equal to minus root 5 by 3. So what is going to come? This minus will come here, that time will be root 5 by 3. Okay. So these are two zeros, factors of f of x is equal to 3x raised to 4 plus 6x cube minus 2x square minus 10x minus 1. This is the, these are two factors of this polynomial. Okay, these are two factors is what? When we will divide, when we will divide by these factors to the given polynomial, that time remainder will be 0. That in that case only we can say that is a factor. Okay, so these things we all are going. Okay, so we are going to find out product of this. So x minus root 5 by 3 into x plus root 5 by 3 is equal to what is going to come? The product of this two. A plus b, a minus b. A plus b, a minus b gives us a square minus b square. So that means we are going to find out a minus b, a plus b. So a square minus b square. So x square minus minus root 5 by 3 square. Okay, so what you will get here, x square minus root 5 by 3 square will become 5 by 3. Okay, so now see, this is the product of this. Now this is divisor which we are going to use to divide the given polynomial. Okay, but we can simplify little bit. Okay, so we can write suppose 1/3, 3 if I am going to take common, 1 by 3. So 1 by 3 suppose I will take common, I need to multiply here by 3. Okay, so what I will get here, 3x square minus 5, 3x square minus 5, see carefully, 1 by 3 into 3x square, what is going to get, 3, 3 will be cancelled, x square, 1 by 3 into minus 5 will be minus 5 by 3, okay, this we have done little change, so 1 by 3 and 3x square minus 5 are the factors of the polynomial, so we can use only 3x square minus 5 for the division, getting everyone? Okay, so now what we are going to do, we are going to take this polynomial here, 3 x raised to 4, 3 x raised to 4 plus 6 x cube minus 2 x square minus 10 x minus 5 divided by 3 x square minus 5. Okay, we have taken this is for division, divisor. Now see, now we need to think about the first term. Okay, what is that? 3 x raised to 4. Okay, so this first term we need to change as same as this. Okay, so here x square, here x raised to 4. So we need to multiply by x square. That is decided. Okay, now we need 3. We need 3. Already 3 is there. Already 3 is there. So not necessary to do anything. So if you multiply x square into 3x square minus 5, what is going to get? 3x raised to 4. That is enough. Okay, so that I am going to multiply directly here 3x raised to 4. Product of this and minus 5 into x square minus 1 x square. So we need to think about the like x square term. So x square term is here. So I can write here minus 5 x square. Okay, product of this. This middle term will remain as it is. So this is minus, this will change into plus. So this is a like term, additive inverse will be cancelled. Okay, not necessary to cancel, automatically it will be cancelled. Okay. So now what is remaining here? 6x cube. So that 6x cube I am taking here. Okay. Minus 2x square plus 5x square. Minus plus will be plus. Minus plus will be minus. 5 minus 2 is 3. 3x square. Sign will become plus. Minus 10x minus 5. Remaining part as it is. Okay. Now we need to think about 6x cube. Now we need to think about 6x cube. Here already x square is there, so we need 1x, so plus x is required. 3 is there, 3 we need to convert it to 6, so I need here 2x. I need here 2x. Okay, so now that we are going to take 2x into 3x square will be 3 to the 6, 6x cube. 2x into minus 5 will be 10x, minus 10x. Okay, so that I am taking here minus 10x. Now, as usual, we need to do subtraction, this will change into plus. So, this 2 will completely cancel, these 3 x square will come as it is, minus 10x plus 10x will be cancelled, and remaining part minus 3 x square minus 5. 3 x square minus 5, 3 x square minus 5. So, here we need to multiply by only plus 1. So, we will multiply by plus 1. So, same term we can take here, 3 x square plus, sorry, 3 x square minus 5. Minus sign, this will change into plus, so remainder will be 0. Okay, both the terms will be cancelled. Now we have a quadratic equation. We have a quadratic equation. Okay, so now what we need to do here? we need to, we can write, see, this is dividend, this is dividend, dividend is equal to divisor multiplied by quotient plus remainder. Okay, we can write in that form, dividend is equal to divisor multiplied by quotient plus remainder. Okay, so see carefully. So see here, f of x, this is f of x, okay, so p of x, this is f of x is equal to, what is going to come, g of x, this is what, g of x, that is divisor multiplied by q of x quotient plus r of x, okay, remainder is 0. So what is g of x, what is it, 3x square minus 5, so that I am taking here 3x square and this is 3x square minus 5 q of x, what is quotient, x square plus 2x plus 1 and remainder is 0, so that you will take, you will not take, no problem, you can take 0 plus 0. Okay, so now after this what we need to do is 3x square minus 5. So to make more easier way, I can write this root 3 into x, root 3 into x square. See, root 3 square will be 3, x square will be x square. This is the basic value, whatever it is given, that is same. Okay. Minus 5, you can write root 5 square. Done. So this is m making square bracket. Okay. Now this is a quadratic equation that we can factorize by splitting middle term. So we can factorize it. X square, we have to factorize 1 in such a way. 1, because 1 into 1 is 1. We need to factorize 1 in such a way. The sum should come 2 and product should come 1. So factors are 1 and 1. That is very easy. Okay. So we can write here x square plus x plus x plus 1. Okay. So this root 3 x square, here see, a square minus b square. Why we have done here changes? To use the identity a square minus b square. Okay. So here we can write root 3x plus root 5. Another bracket, what is going to come? Root 3x minus root 5. Okay. Now here we get in x common, x in bracket, what is going to remain? X in bracket, x plus 1, here will be common 1 in bracket, x plus 1. Okay, so now root 3 x plus root 5, another bracket, root 3 x minus root 5, here x plus 1, another bracket, x plus 1. Okay, or this we can write directly, this is the expansion of x plus 1 bracket square, directly also we can understood x plus 1 bracket square, the expansion of this will get, because you see identical brackets you know. So same directly also we can write, instead of factorizing we can write directly. Okay, so now see here, these all are the factors of f of x, the given polynomial, understood. So we can equate with 0. So what we can write here, root 3x plus root 5 is equal to 0. So we can write this, root 3x is equal to minus root 5. X is equal to minus root 5 divided by root 3. So we can write minus root 5 by 3. Okay. That already that factor was given. That factor was given. Okay. Now this we will take here, root 3x minus root 5 is equal to 0. So root 3x is equal to root 5, x is equal to root 5 by root 3, so x is equal to under root 5 by 3. Next, x plus 1 is equal to 0, x plus 1 is equal to 0, x is equal to minus 1. So here also you get x is equal to minus 1, understood? So how we got here 4 zeros, that is 2 already zeros were given, that is root 5 by root 3 minus root 5 by 3 and minus 1 minus 1. Okay, so these are the 4 zeros. Okay, what is the difference between, we have seen 2 examples, what is the difference, both the examples can be done in the same case, That was the initial example, so I have not shown here. The procedure is C. Factors are given, zeros are given, so we have to convert into factors, x minus 3, and then we need to divide the product of this. Here what we have taken, 1 by 3 we have taken common. Okay, so this example can be done like this also. 3x square minus 5 divided by 3 is equal to 0. 3 will go that side, and we can multiply with 0, it will be 0. Okay, so by this divisor, we have to multiply the remainder will get 0, because remainder will get definitely 0, because these are two zeros. Understood? And we are dividing by the factor, so definitely remainder will be 0. Then f of x, division algorithm we have taken here, g of x into q of x plus r of x, remainder is 0, so that we have taken here g of x, 3x square minus 5, x square plus 2x plus 1, product of this 2 we have taken, this we have converted into a square minus b square, and this we can factorize or directly we can write x plus 1 brackets, doesn't matter. Okay, so this is this way we can find out the remaining zeros of the problem. Thank you. Okay, see here, our third example is, if two zeros of the polynomial f of x is equal to x raised to 4 minus 6x cube minus 26x square plus 138x minus 35 are 2 plus minus root 3, find other zeros. Okay, two zeros are given, two zeros of the polynomial are given 2 plus minus root 3. Okay, so 2 plus root 3 and 2 minus root 3. Okay, that is given to here. Understood? So we can say here we need to find out x is equal to 2 plus root 3 and second x is equal to 2 minus root 3. Okay. So we need to find out the product of this. Okay, we need to find out the product of this. Oh, but see, before this, what we need to do? We can take this 2 here, x minus 2 is equal to root, x minus 2 is equal to root. Okay, here we can take square. Why we need to take square? Because we need to remove this square root. So we can square both the sides. X minus 2 bracket square is equal to root 3 square. Okay, so x minus 2 bracket square, here we need to use a minus b bracket square. So what we get here, x square plus, what is going to get? 4, product of these 2, 2x and x twice minus 4x is equal to root 3 square will be 3. Okay, so now 3 we can take here, x square minus 4x plus 4, this will come minus 3 is equal to 0. So x square minus 4x, 4 minus 3 is 1, 4 minus 3 is 1, that is plus 1 is equal to 0. This is the quadratic polynomial we have. Okay, so this is a factor of the given polynomial. So if we will divide by this factor to the given polynomial, definitely remainder will be 0. Okay, here it is not necessary to find out product of this. Okay, if you find out x is equal to, if you solve this, what is going to get? X minus 2 is equal to root minus root 3. Again we will take square, and square of minus root 3 will be plus 3. Okay, so again you will get the same quadratic equation. You can check your answer. Understood. So x is equal to 2 plus root 3 is a factor of the polynomial, and x is equal to 2 minus root 3 is also a factor of the polynomial. So definitely when you will divide by the factor to the given polynomial, you will get remainder 0. Okay, definitely. So not necessary to solve this. You can divide directly by x square minus 4x plus 1. Okay, so that I am taking here. Okay, so here x raised to 4 minus 6x cube minus 26x square plus 138x minus 35 divided by the quadratic equation we got here, x square minus 4x plus 1. Okay, so now here we get x raised to 4. Here x square we have. So by which we will multiply, by which factor we will multiply? x square will be x raised to x square into minus 4x will be minus 4x cube. X square into 1 will be x plus x2. So that I am going to take here, x2. Okay, see, x square into x square, x raised to 4, x square into minus 4x, minus 4x cube, like that, and x square into 1, x cube. Now, change the signs, due to minus, this will be plus, this will be minus, both things will, both will be cancelled. Minus 6 plus 4, minus 6 plus 4 will be minus 2x cube, minus 2x cube, minus plus, minus 6 minus 4 will be 2, for answer greater number 6, so minus 2x cube. Okay, so minus minus will be plus 26 x square plus x square will be 27 x square. Correct? Minus 26 x square minus x square. So minus 27 x square plus 138 x minus 31. Okay, remaining factors we have taken as it is. Okay, now we need minus 2 x cube. Minus 2 x cube. So we need to multiply by minus 2, x cube is required, so we will take here only single x, so minus 2x into x square will be minus 2x. Okay, as same as this term, as same as the first term we need, minus equity is here minus, here also we need minus, because again we need to get subtraction, so signs are going to change. Okay, so keep in mind, minus 2x cube, now minus 2x into minus 4x, it will be plus 4 2's are 8x, okay, minus 2 into minus 4, plus 8, x into x, x square, okay, minus 2x into 8, minus 2x into 1, minus 2x, okay, so again minus sign, this will change into plus, minus, plus, so these two are going to be cancelled, minus minus will be plus, 27 plus 20, 27 plus 28, sorry, 27 plus 8 will be 35, 27 plus 8 will be 35, so 35 minus 35 x square plus, plus, both are plus, so you can take here plus 140x, 138 plus 240x minus 35. Okay, now we need minus 35, so here x square is there, here x square is there. Okay, so directly we can multiply by minus 35, so here I am taking minus 35, minus 35 into x square will be minus 35 x square. Minus 35 into 4 will be 140. Minus 35 into 4 will be 140. Minus into minus will be changed into plus. Plus 140 x. Minus 35 into 1, minus 35. Okay. So here again minus sign, this will change into plus, minus, plus. 35 plus 35 minus 35 x square will be cancelled. This will be cancelled. This will be plus. So remainder is 2. Okay. So again we have here a quadratic equation. Okay, so now what we need to do here is we can factorize this. We can factorize this. Okay, so now what we can write, f of x, this is f of x. F of x is equal to g of x into q of x quotient of x plus r of x. Okay, so what is f of x? This polynomial that already we have, g of x. What is g of x? X square minus 4x plus 1. Into q of x, what is that? X square minus 2x plus minus 35 plus remainder is 0. So that we will not. Okay. Now both are the quadratic equation, we can factorize easily. So x square minus 4. Here we need to factorize 1. We need to factorize factors. We need to find out factors of 1. The product should come. Product should come minus 2. Okay. So what are the factors of x square minus 4x, x square minus 4x plus 1, how we can factorize it? X square minus 2x minus 35, we can factorize easily. Okay, so other two zeros we need to find out. Now here x square minus 4x plus 1, this we need to factorize. We need to find out factors of 1. Factors of 1, the product should come 1 and sum should come minus 4. Okay, and are there factors, such type of two factors which are satisfying both the conditions? Okay, so here you will not get the factors. So to factorize such type of quadratic equation, we need to use quadratic formula. We need to use quadratic formula. Okay, but here it is not necessary to use, because the factors of these two are already given, 2 plus root 3 and 2 minus 2. Okay, so we will not find out factors of this series. Okay, but you keep in mind we are going to learn this quadratic formula, how to use it. But already the factors of these two are given, so that directly we can write. Factors of this we can easily find out. See, x square minus 2x minus 35. We can factorize factors of 35. Factors of minus 35, 7 5 is 35. We need minus 2. So for greater, we need to give minus 5. So we can write here x square minus 7x plus 5x minus 35. So here we can take common x, x minus 7 plus 5, x minus 7. So x minus 7, another bracket x plus 5. So here what will get factors? X is equal to 7, zeros, x is equal to 7 or x is equal to minus 1. X is equal to 7 or x is equal to minus 1. Okay, so what are the zeros? Zeros of these two are 2 plus root 3, 2 minus root 3, 7 and minus 1. Okay, so zeros of the polynomial are zeros of the polynomials are 2 plus root 3, 2 minus root 3, 7 and minus 1. These are the zeros of the polynomial. Okay, same procedure we have done when this way it is given. We will come like this. That time what we need to do? We need to take this x minus 2 to root 3. Taking square of both the sets, you will get the quadratic equation divided by the quadratic equation to the given polynomial. It is a factor that 0 is given. 0 we have converted into factor, so definitely remainder will be 0. Okay, so by division algorithm we can approach it. Here, see, we cannot factorize by splitting middle term here. So we need to use the quadratic formula. But here, not necessary. Why? Because already factors are given, already zeros are given. So not necessary. Two zeros are already knowing, so that directly we can use 2 plus 4, 3, 2 minus 2, 3. And this is x square minus 2x plus this is quotient which we got here after division. So that we can factorize easily. So it will be two factors, more factors. So totally four factors we have. Okay. So see carefully. We are going to see such type of examples little more in deep. This was the little bit introduction. Directly sums we have done. Okay. So solve those sums and the given worksheets. Thank you very much.